The late 1980s and early 1990s were when several of us were doing PhDs in computing. You could say the first batch of people doing computing PhDs. And in my case, one of the key concepts was that we should do some research that is relevant fairly immediately in Sri Lanka. And so that's why I selected the area of computational linguistics, or what was called natural language processing. And so when we came back, a lot of us found that the internet was not really in Sri Lanka, so we had to spend some time fixing that before we really got on to our research. And I was fortunate enough to have back-to-back sabbaticals in France and the US to reset or reboot my research career in computational linguistics. And I was first interested in, you know, bringing this technology, electronic technology, to our own languages, that is Sinhala and Tamil, and subsequently also interested in translating between these languages, because we were in a context of the ethnic problems, which were largely based on these two cultures. And I'm happy to say that starting in 2004, we have had a kind of a fairly stable research group of between 6 to 10 researchers in this area, drawn from linguistics, from computer science, and some other diverse areas like mathematics and physics, etc. And we've had a very good interaction in this lab. Proud to say that four of these people have now completed their PhDs, two are completing their PhDs, and also we have the first true computational linguist, I would say, who is working with us now. And he's a guy who has so many publications but doesn't have a PhD yet. Hopefully he will also in due course do that. And he is whether he does it or not, he's a very big resource for this country, because of the importance of growing people who can stay in between computing and linguistics. And so we are now involved in several projects, worked with international companies like Microsoft and Nuance. And we've also worked with a lot of donor agencies like IDRC and the Telecommunications Union and the ICT agency of Sri Lanka. And our lab in the University of Colombo, I think, is probably one of the longest standing research labs since we are now celebrating 13 years. And I must say that agencies such as NSF, NRC, donor agencies and ICT agency have really contributed to this work, so that we have been able to produce more than just research papers. We have been able to produce things that are working on the ground. And right now we are producing some tools in optical character recognition for Sinhala, and we've already finished Tamil OCR. We are doing text-to-speech. We have already done text-to-speech for Sinhala some years ago, but we've now graduating to a kind of a human quality TTS for both Sinhala and Tamil. And we've been having kind of limited speaker recognition systems, and we are now focusing on continuous speech recognizer for a wide audience. These are some of the current ongoing projects, but we have also produced a lot of other things such as a Sinhala learning tool, English learning tool, among other things. So overall, I think we have to be, we are really happy that we could contribute to some national cause through this research center. Just as an example, right now we are also helping the encyclopedia office to launch our Sinhala encyclopedia in a very readable and human accessible form. and you will see that coming out very shortly. So our website for most of our services that are available online is subasa.lk. I hope you visit that site and find it useful and share with others.